Entertaining. I'm Meg Graham, AdAge Media Reporter. I'm here with Faith Popcorn, founder and CEO of Faith Popcorn's Brain Reserve, and we're talking about cannabis marketing. But first, a quick message from our sponsor, Quantcast. We'll be right back. I'm here with Faith Popcorn, the founder and CEO of Faith Popcorn's Brain Reserve. And we're hanging out in a backyard in Austin. Let's start out, can you tell us a little bit about your company?
So Faith Popcorn's Brain Reserve works mainly for Fortune 200, and we help them see 10, 15, 20 years ahead, so they kind of don't fall into the pitfalls or the manholes of the future. And so we say, you're going here, but the future's going there. So for instance, everything's gonna be home delivered, right? Completely subscription. The only thing is it won't be a person, it's gonna be a bot. You know, so what do we do with Walmart and supermarkets? They're gonna go away. That kind of vision, but 15 years ago.
So you're here talking about a very interesting subject, cannabis marketing.
Yep.
So tell us, like, what are brands coming to you asking? What are companies curious about?
Is this real? How fast will it be legal? It's going to be $5 billion. It's going to be bigger than the beer market, you know. And even though we have these numbers, and that's 2019, that is next year. And they're still saying, we don't think we should put in our drinks or our food. We don't think anybody's going to really want it. And the biggest people that don't want this to happen are the pharma companies.
Well, what are the sort of considerations above and beyond that cannabis marketers have to think about?
We're seeing that wise marketers, savvy marketers, are looking at different strains. So Netflix came out with a whole thing where say, if you're watching this movie, try this strain.
Yeah.
And then there's like the upscale ones, the Hermès of marijuana,
yeah.
And then the people's marijuana. And there's going to be as many strains and you know, ways to look at marijuana as their wine.
Mm-hmm.
There's going to be marijuana stores that are bigger, like the supermarkets.
Okay, Faith, we're going to play a game.
Oh, good. I love games.
It is called Straight Fire or Total Crap.
Fire!
Cannabis bars at weddings.
Absolutely.
Okay.
Yes. And there'll be longer lines at cannabis bars than they are to get a martini.
Cannabis tea parties.
Like what?
Like high tea.
High tea with cannabis? I don't think so.
Okay.
I think not tea parties. I think cannabis is more modern than a tea party.
Okay.
Maybe cannabis at Starbucks.
Okay. Terpenes in Coke.
I don't know if... Now, Coke's putting alcohol in now.
Yeah.
So I'm not sure that they're going to have the foresight, maybe, you know,
okay,
to really put terpenes in.
Okay.
But if they do, they'd be the first one. I think they do very well. Instead of having a upsetter or interrupter,
yeah,
do it for them.
Okay, Cheech and Chong. Okay, you like it?
I love it.
Okay, great. Celebrity branded paraphernalia.
Absolutely.
Okay.
Lots of it.
Okay.
Miley Cyrus, perfect spokesperson.
Okay.
For this.
Okay, perfect.
Kim Kardashian, not somehow.
Not so much.
No.
She doesn't really fit the archetype.
No, the archetype. Yes, absolutely.
Okay, luxury weed brands.
Absolutely. Luxury. And they're going to be, you know, $25 a vape. What's going to be in them? That's the thing.
Okay.
Special strains, only grown in one corner, just like you know, how they grow wine. Special corners in the world. Where is that place going to be? Is it going to be in Austin?
I don't know. Well, thank you so much. This is so much fun.
My pleasure.
Thank you. Babe.
Really, thank you. You're such a sweetie. You are.